In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at connecting the new Catalyst 8000v virtual router to a Cisco SD-WAN network. Now, if you're unfamiliar with the Catalyst 8000v, you may have known earlier that Cisco had two other products, both the ISRV and the CSR 1000v, both of which were virtual IOSXE routing devices. And the Catalyst 8000v aligns with the new Catalyst 8000 routing platform and kind of consolidates both that ISR and CSRV platform into one new virtual image. So while starting with the latest versions of the virtual IOSXE platform, it is all going to be branded as Catalyst 8000v. Most of the things that you'll see in this video today can apply to the CSR 1000v as well. So to kick this off, let's take a look at the topology that we're dealing with today. If you've seen any of my previous videos, you may recognize this SD-WAN topology. It's pretty simple, has the entire control plane, vManage, vBond, vSmarts, a couple of remote locations that are being represented by vEdge Cloud VMs and a Linux server standing behind them. And then the new thing that I've added here today is a new site ID number 400, that has the same setup with a Linux server that can be used for testing. But this time we have a Catalyst 8000v running as the branch edge device. One last thing before I get started, there are a lot of different ways to bring a 8000v online, including some day zero auto provisioning and, you know, all of that type of magic. But because this is a lab environment, I will only be showing the manual process for bringing up a Catalyst 8000v. With that, let's go ahead and get started. So I'll go ahead and bring up the console of our Catalyst 8000v. And this will probably look similar to any other IOSXE command line interface that we've seen before. One thing to note is that in the earlier days of IOSXE-based SD-WAN, there used to be two completely separate firmware images for an ISR. There would be the traditional IOSXE image that ran standard routing and what we're used to historically, and there would be a new image that would be specifically for the SD-WAN-enabled feature set. With the latest versions of IOSXE code, including what runs on the Catalyst 8000v, we're now running a single consolidated or unified image. So when this image boots up, we'll either be in one of two different modes. We'll be in autonomous mode, which represents the traditional IOSXE standalone routing device, or we'll be in controller mode, which enables us to use new platforms like the Cisco SD-WAN. And it's easy enough to switch back and forth between them whenever we need to. So to find out which mode we're running on right now, we'll do a show version. And if we scroll to the bottom of this, sure enough, we can see that our router operating mode right now is listed as autonomous. And so to begin using the SD-WAN software, we will have to change this to controller mode, and we'll do that with the command controller mode enable. Now the device will warn us that when we go ahead and confirm this change, it's going to go ahead and reboot, wipe everything that we have stored on the device, including the current configuration. So if this is a device that was already in production and you might have some configuration that's worth saving, we'll want to back that up prior to making this change. But since this is a lab device and it's brand new, no config at all, we'll just go ahead and hit continue. And because I'm not going to bother with the day zero config, we'll also hit no here. This reboot might take a couple of minutes, so we'll be right back. Okay, now that our device has rebooted, you might be surprised to see that we're presented with a username and password prompt. We're going to log in with the default credentials, which are going to be admin and admin for both the username and password. And we will be forced to change this immediately upon logging in. Okay, and then we'll be kicked out real quick and we'll have to re-log in with the new username and password, which is going to be admin and whatever we just set. We can check again to make sure that we are in controller mode by doing a show version once more. And scrolling down, we can now see that our router operating mode is controller managed. Okay, now to get the configuration going, we will have to do some manual config on the Catalyst 8000v side before we head over to vManage. So first, let's start off with some of the SD-WAN specific config settings. And if you haven't used an IOSXE based SD-WAN device before, we won't be able to use the typical config T that we're used to on a standard IOSXE device. Instead, we'll have to use a command called config-transaction. This is because all of the configuration done on an SD-WAN device is transactional, so when we enter new commands, they don't take effect on the device until we manually commit those to memory. Once we run that commit command, anything that we've changed on the device will take effect immediately. So first thing we'll do, we'll go ahead and set the hostname to cat8k site 400. Next, we'll set some of the system configuration settings. So we'll drop into system. We'll set our organization name. Then we'll set our site ID to 400. We'll set our system IP. And also, because this is a lab, I will manually set the vBond IP to the IP that we have of the vBond in our lab. Okay, once we're done with that, we'll go ahead and commit these changes for now before moving on. So we'll just type commit. Give that just a second. Next, we're going to do the configuration for our VPN0 interfaces and the tunnel configuration associated to that. So we'll go ahead and go into interface gigabit Ethernet 1, which is my internet facing interface. And we'll set a static IP address of 192.168.99.237. And do a no shut. Then we'll go and create a tunnel interface. For this tunnel interface, we'll do a no shut again. Then we'll do a IP unnumbered for gigabit Ethernet 1. We'll also do a tunnel source of gigabit Ethernet 1. And we'll set our tunnel mode to SD-WAN. And we'll exit out of that. Then we'll drop into the SD-WAN config subtree. And again, we'll set interface gigabit Ethernet 1 as a tunnel interface. And we'll set the encapsulation to IPsec. And for now, we'll go ahead and set the color as Biz Internet. And last but not least, we'll go ahead and set a default route for now to our gateway. And with all that done, we'll commit these configuration changes. Now, depending on your configuration, you might be able to move on to the vManage configuration next. But in my lab, I'm actually using a local certificate authority that has self-signed certificates. And I'm using that CA to sign everything in my lab so that I don't have to go out to the internet and get any of the publicly signed Cisco certificates. So in order to facilitate this, I will have to load the Enterprise Root CA certificate on my Catalyst 8000 so that it will recognize my vManage when they go to negotiate. So I'll have to make a couple of additional configuration changes here to allow that to happen. So if you can see back in my lab diagram, we do have a dedicated management interface out Gigabit Ethernet 3. So let's go ahead and set that up for management access to be able to reach my TFTP server. So back in our config, we'll go ahead and define VRF512 for address family IPv4. And then we'll go ahead into interface Gigabit Ethernet 3. And we'll do VRF forwarding 512. And this one will get our IP address via DHCP. And we'll exit out of this. And last but not least, we'll set our TFTP source interface to Gigabit Ethernet 3 as well. And then we'll go ahead and commit these changes as well. All right, now let's go ahead and do a show IP interface brief. Make sure we have a DHCP address on our Gigabit 3 interface. And looks like we do. So we'll go ahead and do a copy TFTP for our cacert.pem file. And we'll copy that to bootflash. And it looks like that copied successfully. We can go ahead and double check that it is in bootflash by doing a dir bootflash. And I'll go ahead and filter that to just the file we're looking for. And we do have that. So next we'll go ahead and install that using the command request platform software SD-WAN root certificate chain install and then the file location, which is bootflash cacert.pem. Okay, it looks like it's installed. And again, we can validate this by using the show SD-WAN certificate root cacert. And sure enough, does look like we have the correct certificate loaded. We won't go ahead and go through all of this, so we'll hit Q to exit. Okay, now for the most part, we're done on the Catalyst 8000V for now. We're gonna have to go generate our one-time password and keys from vManage to be able to activate this device. So let's go ahead and hop over to vManage now. Now that we're in the dashboard, we can see that everything is up and healthy. We'll go over to the left side and under configuration, we'll select devices. We'll find one of the unused Catalyst 8000V routers, hit the ellipses on the right side, and click generate bootstrap configuration. We'll go ahead and leave this as is and hit OK. And we'll go ahead and copy just the top part of this file out to a notepad file. We'll only need the UUID and the OTP values in order to activate our Catalyst 8000V router. So let's go ahead and bring that back up. And in order to activate this, we're going to use the command request platform software SD-WAN vEdge cloud activate. And then we'll provide the chassis number and the token ID. And once we hit enter, that should start trying to reach out to our vBond in order to begin the onboarding process. So in order to validate, we can start using the command show SD-WAN control connections. And we can see that it's beginning that communication out to vBond and vManage. If we go back to vManage real quick and refresh the page, we can see that our certificate signing request has been generated by the Catalyst 8000V. And that should be automatically signed shortly and then distributed to our 8000V router. We can also see that vManage does already show the host name as Cat8K Site 400 and the system IP. And after just a short period of time, we can see that our certificate has been generated and installed on our Catalyst 8000V. So if we hop back over to that once again, do another show SD-WAN control connections. Sometimes it takes a couple of minutes as the connections are built and torn down between different onboarding steps. Okay, and as you can see on the 8000V now, we're starting to see logs as OMP is coming online. So let's go ahead and do a show SD-WAN control connections one more time. And so sure enough, we have our final connection state, which should be the connections up to both vSmart as well as vManage. Now, if we hop back over to vManage, go back over to the main dashboard, we should see that we have three WAN Edge devices online. Sure enough, we do. That includes the two vEdges that I have already, as well as the new Catalyst 8000. And last but not least, we can go over to Monitor and down to Network, and we can see that everything is up and running there. Not all the BFD connections have come up online just yet, but I'm sure they will shortly. And now if we wanted to, we could go ahead and carry out with our template and policy configuration and provisioning within vManage and go ahead and push that out to our Catalyst 8000 device to bring it fully in line with our SD-WAN network. However, to demonstrate something very quickly, I'm going to go ahead and just configure VPN 10 for our landside service VPN very quickly. Now that I've manually configured the service-side VPN of VPN 10 for our LAN client devices, I wanted to touch on something very quickly that I've gotten asked about a couple of times. So if you're familiar with a lot of the commands on the vEdge platform, you'll notice that a lot of those don't translate one-to-one on the iOS XE-based platforms. So for example, when you make that transition from typical vEdge and Viptela code to iOS XE, you'll notice that a lot of the Viptela commands that you might be used to are now prefixed with the SD-WAN keyword. So for example, on a typical vEdge device, we might do a show BFD sessions. However, on our Catalyst 8000V, we'll have to do a show SD-WAN BFD sessions. And we can see that output here. Now, one thing I've run into a couple of times is what do you want to do when you look at the routing table? On a normal Viptela device, you might do show IP route or show IP route VPN 10, for example. And so on our Catalyst device, we might think that we'd have to use the show SD-WAN IP route command, which in fact doesn't work. And if we try this real quick, we'll see that the device responds back with error, this command is not supported. Now the reason for that is that we're not creating any different routing tables on our iOS XE device when we're running the SD-WAN code. In fact, it's just using the normal built-in mechanisms within an iOS XE device to handle the routing table. So for example, if we just do a show IP route, what we'll see in this output is actually what we would expect to see in the VPN 0 configuration on a normal Viptela or vEdge device. So all of those routes and configuration is now getting dumped into the normal or global routing table on an iOS XE device. And so what that means is if we wanted to see the routing table specifically for our VPN 10, that is actually just configured as a separate VRF within the iOS XE code. So for example, based on my configuration earlier, we can do a show VRF, and we can see that we both have the VPN 512 that we configured for our management interface, as well as 10 for our LAN side network. And so now we can do a show IP route VRF 10, and we should see some of the OMP propagated routes from our other two locations, which for right now, we are seeing it from at least site 200. I did note earlier that it looked like we were having some connection issues between one of the other two vEdge locations, so it looks like that's probably site 300. I can go ahead and fix that in the backend, but I just wanted to demonstrate one of the littler differences between running iOS XE-based SD-WAN code versus the Viptela vEdge code that some people might be used to if they've been running this for a while. Okay, and with that, that's all I have for this video. I hope that this was helpful, and thank you so much for watching.